My name is Andreas Gaiser. I'm a team lead for research and development at Axivium GmbH, and I'm working in the area of architecture verification and semantic analysis of programs. It's a very broad term, so you could say it's the organization of a software project into different kind of components, software components, and how they interact or depend on each other. So this is, in a nutshell, what software architecture is. And normally it's specified or given in the form of a graphical model, like using UML or something similar. So this is a term that derives from the problem that you have your architecture on the one hand, and you're creating that. The architect normally is responsible for that. And you have to code on the other side. And the problem is they should somehow be in sync. Yeah. So if you model something in the architecture, it should reflect in the code and vice versa. And normally you cannot do that because these are two separate things. And architecture verification is a process of comparing the architecture to the code, yeah, and to see whether there are some kind of discrepancies between those two. There are many benefits. So for different stakeholders, so for example, if you are an architect or a project lead, then you can start with architecture verification at the beginning of a project, and you can actually keep track of the progress and see whether something goes wrong in a very early stage of the project, because you have immediate feedback that something goes wrong, that you have your architecture there and in the code something is different. Yeah, then you can take a look at that and maybe think about, what is the problem now here? Is the problem in the architecture? Should we do another design decision there, or is it in the code? And we should fix this right away. So we have very early feedback, and bugs or so can be avoided. For the developer, it's very nice to have this tool because you also get immediate feedback. Yeah, and the problem is, you as a developer, if you develop and you know there is an architecture there, it's nice that it's there, but you normally do not check it. But now you have to check it because you get a violation or something like that. So it avoids bugs and leads to better code. And you have the nice thing that you have a reliable documentation, because now if you have a new colleague, you can say, well, look at the architecture. It's actually verified. So if you have a dependency there, then it's there. And if you have no dependency there, it's not there. And you can actually do, for example, software refactorings in a very nice way and be confident, yeah, that if you change something, then do you know what actually happens. So maybe you have a case tool like Enterprise Architect or Rhapsody, and you have a model there, which is great. Yeah, so this is a very, very nice step if you have that. Our approach is that you can import this into our internal representation. We get the information from the code, you give us the model, we combine them and make this check automatically. Yeah, so this is a check that has to be set up one time, and then it will just work out of the box. And if you change your model, you actually get the changes in the next analysis run. If you change your code, it's the same. Yeah, so this is a quite easy process. Yeah, it's a good point. We have a lot of stuff going on. For example, if you look at architecture verification, for example, we have a lot of customers in the automotive industry. There are standards like AUTOSAR and adaptive AUTOSAR, and a lot of challenges for the architecture domain. Yeah, and we also have interesting topics like freedom from interference, and also things like security is becoming more and more important. So this is also something which is interesting and where architecture can be of tremendous help, and architecture verification in particular. So I would say, yeah, there's a lot of stuff that we actually could do in this area.